Hello student, Saira. Today we are going to start our first chapter, that is input-output devices. In the previous class, you learned what is computer. Now we are going to understand how computer work. Before that, tell me one thing. Computer is a single machine? No. So let us understand computer system. Computer is having four different parts and many other parts also, but basically having four parts. That which are they? Keyboard, mouse and CPU. All together that is called computer system. Now all these parts attached to the CPU. Student, all we have the brain. Without brain, we can't think, we can't work. As the same way, computer also have a brain, that is called CPU. CPU is the brain of the computer and it is giving accurate result. It does not require too much time to give the result. It do the perfect calculation. That is why we call computer is a smart machine. Okay, now we are going to learn how the computer work or which are the basic function to work. Computer system perform three basic functions. That is input, process and output. First, input unit. The information which we enter into the computer is known as input. It can be words, numbers, pictures or sound. Input is entered into the computer through input devices. For example, keyboard, mouse, joystick and scanner. This is called input unit. Second is a process unit. The action taking by machine to work on input and change it into output is called output processing. Now what is output unit? The thing which we get from machine after it works, it is called output unit. Let us understand the function with the help of example. Take an example of mango shake. We required mango, sugar and milk. All these things need put in a grinder. These things we called input. All the things blending in a grinder is called process. The mango shake given by the grinder is called output. This is called input, process, output is the first example. Okay, take one more example. Adding two numbers. Input, two numbers to be added are given to the computer using an input devices. Second, the process of additions operation is performed on these two numbers. Adding two numbers, that is 3 plus 7 equals to 10. You can see the figure 3 plus 10, 7 equals to 10. Output means result is displayed on the screen. The 3 plus 7 equals to 10. This is called result. That is called output. This is the another one example of input, process, output. Now we are going to understand how computer system work. Computer system work with the help of hardware and software. Now what is hardware? Hardware refers to physical part of a computer that we can touch, feel. It means you can see with your eyes that parts of called hardware and feel it also. This is called hardware. For example, keyboard, we can touch the keyboard, we can see the keyboards. Second example is speaker. Third is CPU. This is the example of hardware. Now we are going to understand what is software. Software are computer program that are installed in a computer for different application on the basis of nature of job. We select software. It does not matter what a program does. It is still called software, or software is a set of instruction that helps the hardware to work in a desired manner. Example of software. MS Word is used for document. MS Excel is used for accounting purpose, and Paint is used for making a drawing. Now we are going to understand how hardware and software are interdependent. What is the meaning of interdependent? Interdependent means dependent on each other. Without software, a computer can't work. Similarly, if hardware is not there, the software is of no use. For example, take an example to listen to music. We require a music system. The music system, CDs and DVDs are hardware because we can touch them. Can you touch the song? No, that is software. So here we need both the things to enjoy the music. Now, for operating a computer, we need to carry some basic components that are keyboard, mouse, CPU and monitor. Apart from this, some additional part can be attached. So a computer known as peripherals. Example, printer, scanner, modem, etc. So student, here we learn what is computer system, what is input, process, output, and about hardware and software. I hope students, this is clear to all of you. Here we are going to stop the chapter. We will continue the chapter from next class. Thank you, and once again, Sai Ram.